Japanese businesses in particular are saying that they want to have clarity and certainty as soon as possible. The first thing to say is that nothing changes immediately. When we've been talking to our Japanese partners, we've been very clear that whilst the UK remains a member of the EU, and you know that's likely to be for at least another 2.5 years, we will continue to be active members of the EU that have the same rights and obligations as other member states in the meantime. And in terms of free trade agreements, where I think automotive companies have a big interest, the EU-Japan free trade agreement is something that I think a lot of you know. The UK has been the leading champion of reaching an agreement on that, and we will continue to support that whilst we remain members of the EU. In the meantime, the government will be working out what its negotiating position will be with the European Union. The Prime Minister has been very clear that we're not going to rush into it. We know that Japanese businesses in particular are saying that they want to have clarity and certainty as soon as possible. But what we've been explaining is that that probably isn't the best way to support their interests. And by taking time and working out more clearly what it is we're aiming for, what we hope to achieve through the negotiations, we stand a better chance of achieving an outcome that supports the interests of business in the UK.